All right. Good morning. Yeah, let's do it, dude. I think we're playing the mirror. Come back typically plays elves. What's up, Prima Plum? Thanks for stopping in. They're mulling to five. That can't be good. So, they would typically hope to turn two. Because we're just going to try to go for a healthy turn three. Basically do a little ramping on turn one, cast a visionary out, turn two, cast a symbiote, bounce a visionary into turn, glimpse, turn three. Zenith would be a good start for them. Okay, so that's a really good start for them. I don't think there's a reality in which I can turn two here, because if I go Glimpse Heritage Druid, I would need a Cradle to continue, and that would only get me Visionary anyway, so I think we need to stick to the original plan. Okay, that's a Cradle. So maybe in this case, then, I just want to hold up Arbor and hold the Wirewood Symbiote for go time, so... We just gotta hope that they don't have a nuts turn two. They mulled to five, so probably not. Yeah, it's definitely the mirror match. Comeback is definitely an Elves player. So it looks like they are going for the turn two. That's not Aquarian Ranger, so things could be worse. Cradle would be a great play. Virtual Rangers would be a way to continue. Sorry, friend. I know the feel. I could fizzle here. Wow, so what's interesting about this is we don't have an untapper. And nothing can attack. So if I natural order here, the hoof is going to stand alone to get... Or I could natural order for a Wirewood Symbiote. because it's not lethal. That's a really weird play that doesn't come up often. Oh my gosh. I don't have mana to keep going. I can't keep going. They don't have the natural. Okay, whew. What a weird game, man. That was a really weird game, man. I had a natural order for a symbiote, draw three off of Visionary, and still fizzle? What in the world? Hand's got a lot of mana, it's a symbiote, but it doesn't have any action. And they're starting with 7. That's better, at least it has a Visionary and a Shepherd. Yeah, somehow we won. Ming Empire, thank you for the Prime subscription. That means a lot. Welcome. Welcome. Thank you. Alright, so Thoughtseize has to take one of these two cards because they're the most actionable. That is not what I would have picked. Cradle is right here. Natural order was a sick trip. So, I guess Heritage Druid would have put me into a turn 2 natural order. They have another Thoughtseize, though. So they rip the natural order. Makes sense. Maybe they drew it. Oh, wow. Speaking of drawing things. Yeah, I want to deploy everything. Attack puts them to 14. We can draw the other spell, I believe. Alright, so we have, like, Shepherd set up to do some damage. This could be good. Cradle would be sick. Hit the cradle? No. Oh hey, awesome! Also, AKA Achilles, what's up, man? Nice. Well, I'll be uploading today's as well, and then I'll be uploading VODs from this week's streams as well. I'm gonna upload a lot more content, so. Well, I do need to top deck a land to make the Shepherds go off. Oh. Well... Sweet. Oh yeah, thanks for the follow, Ming Empire. I hate team killing. Yeah, it was kind of weird. All right, so I wanted to actually just, since we finished that one so quickly, I'm gonna start up a side league here. Oh, I forgot. I'm in the middle of a league with the same list. So this is just for posterity's sake. Or I'm 2-1 in this league right now. Hey, good morning, Ray. Welcome. My chat's gotten so much more active these days. I actually had to put this up somewhere where I can keep an eye on it in real time. It's really cool to see all y'all here this morning with me. Happy to provide that Elves material. Man, Lee is slow in the mornings of the challenge, I forgot. Alright, another match real quick. This hand is, like, not very good. We're on the draw? No, I still hate it. This hand isn't great either. However, it does have two draws and a bunch. If it's like Delver or something, we do have a bunch of land. I'm gonna keep it on the faith that we'll draw Wonder. Once upon a time. Finds an Urborg. I guess we're up against Deaths, which this... We want to be faster against, typically. Reclaim up. So ideally we're going to drop two visionaries next turn, or I guess ideally, there's no way we can really go off next turn. Even drawing glimpse would be too sketchy. Maybe we just drop one visionary next turn. Not really sure yet. Alright, sweet. Glimpse off the top would be so sick. Hopefully they don't have the Hex Mage here, but they probably do. Maybe not. I guess not. Let's go! Let's not go anymore. What the hell? Alright, it's fine. It's fine. A good win rate? I mean, like, 4-1, 5-0. Those are, like, where we want to be. And that's... I end up in the 4-1 way too often. I can't get trophies. I'm, like, banned from trophies, I swear. But we can luck it. We can use that same, like, luck out and go, like, luck out in challenges, you know? Get it? That's how we make top 8s. Okay, so as long as my opponent doesn't thought seize me here, we probably win. DJ Cumberbun. I'm a man cheetah. He seemed impressed by the way you came in. Tell us a story. I know you're not boring. I was afraid that you would not insist. You sound so sleepy. Just take this, now leave me. I said, please don't slow me down if I'm going too fast. Yeah, it's definitely decent. Definitely what you want to be doing. 3-2 just, like, returns your entry plus $2, basically. 4-1 is like get your entry back plus $10, like if you like calculate the chests. More than that, because like the chests are $2 and X cents or whatever. And again, when you like, if you take like all those 4-1s, that calculates to like an 8-2 record, which is like generally pretty good enough to like get into top 8s of challenges and whatnot. I can't remember if I bring in Progenitus in this matchup. Probably on the play I do, but probably not on the draw. Yeah, whatever.
What are you, man, cheetah?
Yeah. Cool. You like it?
Yes.
Hand moves pretty fast, so I think this is what we want. We're gonna save the Zenith for Wirewood Symbiote. Just go wide. Why not?
Keep that in mind. I designed this rhyme to explain in due time. All we can find, no time is a valuable thing.
Almost missed this. So we have one turn to figure shit out here, basically. Okay, unless they have crop rotation, we have two turns, but... Trying to explain. Let's go! Alright, 3-1 in the league. 7 matches left. Let's do a little transition. A little death clock, why not?
Yeah.
Damn. I have not 100% of that solo before. That was good. That was a fucking personal achievement for the day. And now for a classic.
You get a shiver in the dark, it's raining in the park, but meantime. Sound of the river, you stop and you hold everything. A band is blowing Dixie, double fall time. You feel alright when you hear the music ring. Well, now you step inside, but you don't see too many. In other places, but the horns, they blowing that sound way on down south. Guitar George, he knows all the chords. Man, he's strictly rhythm, he doesn't want to make it cry or sing. This dead and old guitar is all he can't afford. When he gets up under the lights to play his thing, saving it up Friday night with the Sultans, with the Sultans of Swing. Yeah. And a crowd of young boys there fooling around in the corner. Best brown baggies in their platform soul. They don't give a damn about any trumpet playing band. It ain't what they call rock and roll. And the Sultans, yeah, the Sultans that play Creole. Thank you.
One match remaining, but they're in game two. Gosh, what is going on in there? A lot of people today.